Hey dolls, I'm back and I'm finally ready to unbox the Monster High family of Cleo de Nile. So as I've said numerous times in other videos, this is like a dream come true to me because I had an idea for Cleo de Nile that has to do with kids for like 2 years now. Like ever since I started this channel, I have wanted to do something with them, and I think it might be hints to that on dollworldshows.com still, matter of fact. But anyways, I got this from Target. I got her from Target. It's probably been like a month now ago that I have her, but I went to Target again last night and they do still have her. I went to another Target, they had her like probably three or four more of this pack. This is $19.99 at Target. And then, in the other Target that I went to, they didn't have Pharrah de Nile, but at this Target, they do have Pharrah de Nile. So I got her for $8.99. So I'm happy because now I have the complete set. So I'm super excited that I didn't get to unbox her yet, because I would have been like, no. I wanted to be able to do them all at the same time. So I'm happy we have all of the de Niles in the building. Y'all know I have like all of their characters. I also have Pharrah de Nile, who made her guest appearance on the Bad Ghouls Club. Alright, so without further ado, let's go ahead and unbox them. Of course I'm gonna show you the back and everything and see what it says, but let's go ahead and get these girls open. On the back, we have Sandy de Nile, Cleo de Nile, of course, Pharrah de Nile, and Lux de Nile. It says the de Niles are a closely wrapped family who think a night of watching movies or playing games together is creepiferic fun. Okay, that's a new one, Mattel. But yeah, it's creepiferic fun. So I guess the little board piece that Pharrah de Nile comes with, I guess that's the game table or whatever. And on the back of the Pharrah de Nile box, it says the same thing. Now, as you know, we already have the family of Claudine Wolf. That was the first family that we got. I don't have the family of Laguna. I did see Ebby Blue though. I saw Ebby Blue in Target, and I did see Laguna and Kelpie Blue in Walmart. I just haven't gotten them yet. I might in the future. I'm just not as crazy about Monster High as I used to be. If I was really into Monster High, I would have already bought all of them, but I just don't, like, ever since they came out with the new versions of them, I'm not crazy about them. I think the best version, the new version, is Cleo de Nile. Like, they still have Cleo de Nile slaying with the new dolls. I actually like her version of the new dolls, but like, I didn't like the Claudine Wolf. The Laguna Blue is okay, but anyways, we're not gonna get into that. Like I said, Cleo de Nile anyways and Claudine Wolf, they're like two of my favorites off of Monster High anyways. Okay, so if I don't get any of the other ones, to make a long story short, I have to have them. So, and she looks fabulous, and I like the fact that she's articulated. Now I'm gonna come back real quick before we open her, and I'm gonna show you the other ones that I have. So as you can see, my first repaint ever was this Claudine Wolf doll. She's the one that comes with their set. I really didn't like how she looks. They didn't do Claudine Wolf any justice in the new collections, if you ask me. I think they did a horrible job with Claudine as far as her fashions, as far as her look. They just didn't do my favorite doll any justice with the new line of Monster High dolls. So yes, I repainted her. So she's not even Claudine Wolf, she's like Claudine, she's Rihanna Wolf right now. So I don't know if they recognize their sister, because she turned into Rihanna Wolf with the repaint, you know what I'm saying? And I do have that video coming, y'all. I promise. I'm so far behind on videos because of school. Even though I was still dropping videos, I was not dropping half of the videos that I recorded, so I still got a lot on the way. But this is Paula Wolf, then we have Barker Wolf, and then we have Meredith, which is really mad with me because she was just in her mommy's arms, Claudina, keeping up with the wolves, still on the way, especially around the holidays, okay? But yeah, I just wanted to show y'all the other family, and then of course she's my repaint. But without further ado, let's go ahead and open up the de Niles. Thank you. So now that we have them out of the box, we can see them a little bit better. First, you can see their little play set right here. I guess these are like the two game pieces, and then they have a die, a gold die, of course, because they are the Deniles. And then it looks like, you know, a little game board. So that's what Pharrah came with. That was in her package. And I know I didn't take any class in the way that I opened them. I didn't use scissors carefully or anything like that. I ripped them open like I used to open up my Christmas presents when I was 6. But, you know, Monster High's packaging is not spooktacular anymore. So it really doesn't matter. But anyways, let's take a closer look at the dolls. Alright, so the first one that we're going to look at is Pharrah de Nile. And I think she's super cute. I love this little gold headband that she has on. I like her purple and black hair. It looks like Pharrah de Nile and Lux de Nile are definitely matching in the hair color. She has purple eyes. She has this little star right here, like her sister has a diamond on her face. And I think her dress is really cute. I do like these little Monster High dolls because their clothes are removable and they're not molded like the Chelsea dolls. And she also comes with a removable necklace and some tennis shoes. Okay, unlike my poor Wolf dolls, they didn't give them any tennis shoes. They just gave them bare feet. But yeah, she is cute. I really like her. I'm not disappointed with the prices at all neither. If it was at Walmart, it would have probably been a dollar cheaper. That's usually how it works with Target and Walmart. As far as the dolls are usually a dollar cheaper at Walmart. But I don't have a problem with the price. I really like the set. Then let's take a look at, I forgot what this little one's name is. This one is Sandy de Nile. So we have Sandy de Nile, which is the baby. She is a girl. And then she comes with the baby bottle. All right. And of course, she already, from a baby, she knows her birthright. Okay. So she has her headpiece on, her crown. And then she does have molded clothes on, which I am not bothered about because she is too tiny to be swapping out her little clothes. Okay. And then she has an onk on her shirt, which I love it. I love it, okay? And then we have Lux de Nile, and he has some kind of crown on his head. Not sure what it is, but it's cute. It's very royal. His outfit is regular, however, even though he does have the gold edges to give him some pizzazz. And I love his little flip-flops that he got on. I like how they styled him. And it looks like he comes with a cell phone. I'm not really sure what this is. No, this looks like it could be juice, matter of fact, like a bottle of juice, you know, like those sipping packs. So use your imagination, use it how you want. It could be a cell phone, an iPod, I don't know, or some juice, maybe some apple juice, because it does look like it's a little apple on there. So I don't know, but I think that's what it is. Of course, his clothes is removable as well, but as you can see, him and Pharrah de Nile, their skin is just completely, they're mummified. They're mummified. I guess it's cool. I'm not tripping because they're just the little kids anyway. But the whole little kid gang is completely mummified, okay? But yeah, so I wanted to show y'all them. And I have them sitting down because I just really don't feel like going through the struggle of trying to balance them out. And now let's take a look at Cleo. So I love this Cleo de Nile doll. She's probably my favorite, actually, of all of them. Because I have, like, two other Cleo de Nile dolls. Let me get them. These are all of my Cleo de Nile dolls that I have. And this is my least favorite one of them. The only thing that I like about her is the design that she has around her eye, which represents the Eye of Horus, for those of y'all who don't know, Heteru. Anyways, but yeah, I like that. And then she has the crown of Maat on, which I love. So I love her symbolism in this doll. But then with this doll, out of these two, this one is my favorite. I just really didn't like her face. Like, it's okay. You see what I'm saying? I don't really like her makeup. And her skirt is just too short. Like, come on. It was just too skimpy. She can't even think about bending over. Like, okay. Let me show you their shoes, too. I do like all of their shoes. But yeah, and then this one used to be my favorite. I don't play with these dolls though. Like, I don't know how her hair got so tore up, because I actually keep her on a shelf. Like, she's on a shelf with all my Monster High dolls. If y'all are interested in seeing my Monster High collection, let me know, because I have so many Monster High dolls. I just don't play with them as much anymore because I'm all back into my Barbies. But yeah, so, and then out of these two, this is the old school Monster High, which I love. I used to just love their attitudes, their characters. So I love this doll, but I like this doll also. I feel like they did a good job with her. I feel like right here she looks, I guess more mature. Like she looks more like a motherly doll right here. And this looks like maybe, even though I know they were in high school, this looked like how you would look maybe like in your early 20s or like your teenage years, you know, like a little bit of spunk. She got the heavy lipstick on, the lip liner, the eyeliner. But this doll, because she has less makeup, to me, she just looks more mature and more motherly. And maybe like she works in an office. But that's just my opinion. So these two are my favorites. I would still always love this doll. I don't have her other piece of her outfit on. I need to put it back. That blue piece that goes around. So that's not her complete outfit. It's almost her complete outfit. But yeah, I just wanted to show y'all the other ones for comparison to how the new dolls look. But out of all of the dolls, like I said, she was probably the one that I was least disappointed with, because I like how her new model came out. And then I also like the fact that she's actually articulated, like the old dolls used to be. I don't know if the limbs can come out or not, and I honestly am not interested in finding out, because I mean, who just wants to mutilate their Monster High dolls? But what I will say about it is that this is way more sturdy. Like, you know how with the made-to-move Barbies, sometimes it's a little bit hard to do it because it's, like, really tight in place? That's how she feels. Like, that's how these feels. And we know that the old-school Monster High dolls, like, their limbs are a lot looser. And if you make the wrong move, their limbs will pop right on off. But with this one, it doesn't feel like that. But I'm happy that she's still all the way articulated. You see what I'm saying? That's the difference between her and the Claudine Wolf that I got. As you can see, she's not articulated anywhere. She can't bend her elbows. She can't bend her knees. And that was a major disappointment. And these dolls, their packages are basically the same price. So that's the two distinctions between them. Of course, I love Claudine, especially now that she's Rihanna. We're going to call her Claudine Rihanna Wolf. Okay. But I love her now. I just wish she was articulated. I actually tried to put this head on an articulated body after I was done doing it, but it didn't work out. Her head was moving all over the place, so I have to keep her on this body. But it's fine. Since she was my first repaint, I just keep her for decoration anyways. But yeah, back to the Denials. I'm very pleased with this doll. I like her dress. That's how the back of it looks. She comes with like a cup. Of course, she has golden juice, which is probably the elixir of life, and a towel or something. That's the same thing that Claudine Wolf came with, the towel. So I don't know if they're trying to say something like the Monster High dolls need to wash up a little bit more. But yeah, and then she got these little green shoes on. So I'm excited about it. I like this. All right. So y'all let me know what y'all think about the family set. I'm happy to finally have all of them. I would not have felt complete without Pharrah. I'm not going to tell y'all how they're going to be related. All I'm going to say is stay tuned, because I have a whole new series coming, and it's going to be kind of tied along with Keeping Up with the Wolves, because we know that Cleo de Nile and you know, Claudine are best friends. Well, they're not. It's really Claudine and Draculaura. But as people grow up, sometimes times change. I know me and my best friends growing up, we did some shifts. Like, people who I was closer with in high school, when I got to college, I became closer with some of my other friends, even though we're still all friends. So sometimes the shifts do happen. So now that they're grown, because my Monster High dolls are grown now. They're not in high school anymore. At least not most of them. Let's see how this plays out. So anyways, I hope that y'all enjoyed this review. I'm very pleased to have this set. I love them. I think it's worth the price. Like I said, I got these from Target. And make sure, if you do shop on Target, like I mentioned in another video, download the Cartwheel app, because they have a lot of discounts a lot of the times. They can really help you save money on your toys and just other things that you might buy. So I hope that y'all enjoy this video. I love y'all. Talk to y'all later. Peace.